Let us now go to the fourth question. Refer to question number 4. Question number 4 says, which among the following is or nucleophiles? The four species that are given there are H2O, then we have NH3, followed by OH minus, and the fourth one is BH3. The question asks is, which among these four that are given there are nucleophiles? The correct choice for this, correct option for this question is option 3, which includes A, B and C. BH3, A, B and C. D is actually BH3, is not a nucleophile. It is an electron deficient compound. Therefore, it cannot be a nucleophile. Therefore, excepting D, the remaining three are nucleophiles. Therefore, the correct choice is option 3, which includes A, B and C. Now, the next question that we can go is refer to question number 5 in the series. This question says, which among the following are electrophiles? Just like how to identify the nucleophiles, we can identify the electrophiles in this group. The various groups that are, the various species that are given are hydrogen, then NO2 plus, then SO3 and H2O. These are the four that are given. Identify the electrophiles among them. Electrophiles are electron deficient species. Now, H is an electrophile. Nitronium ion NO2 plus is an electrophile. The sulfonating species SO3 is also an electrophile. And therefore, A, B, C are electrophile, which corresponds to choice 1 in the options that are given. So, 1 is the correct choice for the question number 5. Let us now go to question number 6. In question number 6, the question asked is, the total number of structural isomers possible for the compound C4H8. The number of possible isomers, options given are 2, 3, 5 and 4. So, the choice is, correct choice is 3, which corresponds to 5 structures. Now, what are the 5 structures that correspond to the, what are the 5 structures that correspond to the formula C4H8? I will give the structures of all this. 1 C4H8 is a cyclobutane molecule. The other one is methyl cyclopropane. We have to bring out 5 structures, out of which one structure is cyclobutane, the other structure is methyl cyclopropane. The third one is CH2. The question asked is, how many structures are possible for, structural isomers are possible for the structure 3, 4 corresponding to the formula C4H8. We are given 3 structures for this. Now, the fourth structure will be, it is only structural isomers that is asked, not the stereoisomers. So, this is the fourth structure, and the fifth structure corresponding to this will be CH3, this is something which I referred earlier, which is isobutylene. These are the 5 structures that are available. So, the correct answer, the option for this question number 6 is 3, which corresponds to 5 structures, and the 5 structures are, one is cyclobutane, methyl cyclopropane, these two are the cyclic structures. The acyclic structures are 1-butene, 2-butene and then isobutylene or 2-methylpropene. So, these are the 5 structures that agrees with this. So, the choice is 3 for this question.